Welcome back. Japan's ruling party is looking to shake things up a bit and allow women to attend key political meetings. But the offer comes with a condition that is causing outrage. Joining us now from Tokyo with the details, CNN's Selina Wang. Okay, tell us about the proposal and the reaction to it in Japan.
Well, Michael, I've spoken to many women here in Japan who say that this is just another example of sexism in Japan's elderly, male-dominated political elite. Now, this proposal came from the ruling party, which was that more women should attend these key meetings, but on the condition that they do not speak. Now, only two of the party's 12-member board are women, and only three of its 25-member general council are women. I spoke to Tomomi Inada, one of Japan's most prominent female lawmakers, and she told me that Japan is a democracy without women. This is what Japan's leadership looks like. The ruling party now wants more women at key meetings as long as they don't talk. The Liberal Democratic Party proposed allowing five female lawmakers to join its nearly all male board meetings, but only as observers. Toshiro Nikai, the party's 82-year-old secretary general, said it's important for women to, quote, understand what kind of political discussions are happening. So it's about letting them take a look. Outrage ensued. Social media users decried the LDP proposal as tone deaf and yet another example of deep-rooted sexism in Japanese society. Japanese writer Mieko Kawakami tweeted that women are treated as second-class citizens forever here in Japan. Others mocked the idea as a field trip for women. The proposal comes in response to criticism that the LDP's board is dominated by men. On February 15th, Tomomi Inada, who is Japan's second female defense minister, wrote this letter to Nikai, asking for more representation of female lawmakers. Japan is a democracy without women. The perception that politics should be done by men still widely exists here in Japan. And the perception that good women are those who behave properly and don't push themselves forward also still exists. Just days before Yoshiro Mori, the 83-year-old Tokyo Olympics chief, resigned after making sexist comments that women speak too much during meetings, resulting in international condemnation. Experts say Japanese politicians have gotten away with blatantly sexist comments in years past, but no longer.
10, 20, 30 years ago, people would have just sort of brushed it off. Oh, that's another politician making, you know, a foot in the mouth comment and write it off. Whereas now, particularly in this world of social media, you can't get away with it that easily.
The World Economic Forum calls Japan's gender gap by far the largest among all advanced economies, ranking it 144th place on its political empowerment index between Qatar and Iran. Fewer than 10% of Japan's House of Representatives are women, just 46 out of 465 members. Inada says Japan is still 20 years behind other developed countries in gender equality and that more drastic change is needed. I think we should introduce a quota system. We are proposing to make 30% of candidates for elections female. Without doing this, I don't think we will have change for even another 10 or 20 years.
What about yourself? Do you have plans to try and become prime minister?
She says yes, and she'll keep challenging the status quo. Now, the women I spoke to say that we are starting to see a shift here in Japan. More people, both men and women, are expressing their outrage on social media in hopes for real and lasting change that is not just superficial. Now, Tomomi Inada told me that one of the key challenges is changing this deeply ingrained mindset in Japan of these traditional roles for men and women. She said that it is still widely accepted for there to be no women or just one woman in key meetings. But she said it is a step forward that people are now being held accountable for these sexist remarks that in years past would have gone unnoticed or been just brushed off as a joke. Michael?
All right, Selina Wang, extraordinary, isn't it? It is 2021. Thanks for that, Selina Wang.